Good evening and a very warm welcome to the Penguin Annual Lecture 2015. My name is Himali Sodhi and I'm the children's publisher at Penguin Random House India. This is a very special evening for us at Penguin Random House, for today we have the pleasure and the privilege to present in one of India's best loved authors, who has delighted generations of readers with his writings and continues to do so still. Our speaker this evening is the one and only Ruskin Bond. Ruskin Bond is the ninth in a series of celebrated authors and public personalities who have delivered the Penguin Annual Lecture. That illustrious list includes names such as Amartya Sen, Thomas Friedman, Ram Guha, His Holiness the Dalai Lama, APJ Abdul Kalam, Amitabh Bachchan, and Dan Brown. We started the Penguin Annual Lecture in 2007 with a commitment to bring some of the finest minds in the world in direct contact with readers and audiences. It was the first lecture of its kind to be organized by a publishing house in India and was part of a larger commitment to spread the joy of reading and of books to as many people as possible. This evening's lecture, however, might well be the most special one we have hosted. Ruskin Bond wrote his first book, The Room on the Roof, when he was 17. It was published in 1956. It remains one of the most powerful, most evocative books ever written. In 2016, we celebrate the 60th anniversary of The Room on the Roof with a special illustrated edition. Yes, it's been an incredible 60 years since The Room on the Roof was published. And in that time, Ruskin has given us over 500 novellas, short stories, essays and poems, and has published over hundreds of books. Ruskin is one of India's most popular authors and also one of the most celebrated. He won the Sahitya Academy Award in 1993, was awarded the Padma Shri in 1999, and the Padma Bhushan in 2014. Many of his books are perennial bestsellers, and some have been made into very popular films as well. Ruskin's writings have endured marvelously. Children today are as enchanted by Ruskin's stories as we were dozens of years ago. We read Ruskin's stories as children and read his writings again as we grew up. We then found generations of new readers delighting in Ruskin's warm, cozy world of genial wit, anecdote, a deep understanding of people, and a genuine love for nature. I think I can confidently say that if many of us in this auditorium were to name our favorite author whose writings we keep going back to for joy and for comfort, it would be Ruskin Bond. And if there's one character that many of us have identified with, it is Rusty, who first made an appearance 60 years ago and who is still going strong, as Ruskin's new book, Rusty and the Magic Mountain, proves. A life and legacy in words such as Ruskin's is rare indeed. In this age of frenetic haste, he lives simply in the famed Ivy Cottage in Landor, answers his correspondence by hand every day, does handwritten first drafts of stories which he then types up on his machine. A living legend, Ruskin is an icon of what an author is supposed to be. But why did he become an author in the first place? What has kept him going for 65 years? How do the things he sees around him, the hills, the trees, the bazaars, and the people, become part of the magical world he creates through his words? I know we're all waiting to find the answers to some of these questions and to get to know the legendary author better. Post the lecture, Ruskin will be in conversation with noted journalist and television presenter Sunil Sethi. I won't stand in your way any longer, ladies and gentlemen. It is a delight to present Mr. Ruskin Bond, who will speak on the joy of writing.
Thank you, Himali, for all those kind words about me. And it's a chilly evening, but you're a warm audience, I can tell. And thanks for coming. This is just to impress you, actually. I'm not by nature a lecturer. And I used to resent being lectured to when I was at school or younger. So I'm a little apprehensive, especially when I see so many of you here. But I think that there are amongst you many who are aspiring writers, or maybe you've written books, or plan to write them, or are in the process of writing them. So if anything I can say could help you or encourage you on the way, I would be very happy to to be that person. When I was a boy, I was, of course, a prolific reader, as I think any writer would be. So, and amongst the authors that I liked, there was one called A.E. Milne, M-I-L-N-E, and he wrote essays, he wrote short stories, he wrote plays, very successful plays, even a detective novel. He really enjoyed writing every moment of his adult life. But oddly enough, he's only remembered for one small children's story that he wrote about his son's teddy bear, Winnie the Pooh. And so to his chagrin, he's remembered for this teddy bear, not for all the stories and other things that he'd written. Well, that's the irony of life and the irony of the writing life too. Sometimes you can put your heart and soul into something, but it may not be appreciated. And something else that you toss aside or feel isn't really anything special, it might just catch the reader's fancy and become a classic.